There is only one reality, one truth. Your life gains meaning from only one thing, fear. Fear motivates. You eat because you are afraid to starve. You live because you are afraid to die. And you will win because you are afraid of the pain of losing. Now, Kenny doesn't think he can push this weight up, do you, Kenny? But he can and he will. And that proves my point. He has fear. Push it. Push it.
You are an embarrassment.
All right, this Friday we have the time trials for the county finals. We do it then and we kiss the season goodbye. There is no before, there is no after. So you will run your fastest, you will post your best times, or you will answer to me. All right, that's it. Get your sorry butts out of here. Kenny,
I want to see you in my office in 5.
Coach Billy Bolt believes that fear and winning run hand in hand. But fear is a dangerous motivator that's liable to strike back against those who live to inspire it.
You think you're pretty fast, huh? You think you're a winner?
I do okay.
Well, you're not, you know that? You've been given a little natural talent, but you're wasted. You've been posting the same lousy times ever since you were a freshman. It is an embarrassment to me. It makes me look like I got a loser in my hands.
Oh, come on, I'm not a loser.
Kenny, winners don't choke.
What do you mean?
Last year, Middlesex, 3rd place, choke. This year, regionals, didn't even place, choke.
I tried.
Not good enough. What's your fastest time in 100?
10.6.
Says here that the school record is 10.2. That's a half second faster.
I know.
Set 24 years ago, and nobody's even touched it.
I've heard.
Nobody's beaten my record. Nobody's come close. You understand?
Yes, sir.
No, I don't think you do. You see, when you're a winner, you stay on top. You have no fear, and that's something you're never going to understand.
Mom never understood it either, right?
That's talk back to me. You're a loser.
Come on, Chloe.
I'm not interested.
That's not what Chuck Warren said.
Get lost. Back off, Nick.
Hey! Leave her alone. Move it along, Jocko. Oh,
shut up, Nick. Get away from me.
You ain't worth it, babe. Big runner man, huh? Chase this.
Thanks.
Hey. You okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
What are you doing here so late? You have a meeting or something?
Right. Pep squat. Try detention.
Well, that was my next guess. Can I give you a lift?
Look, that was real nice back there, but I don't do jocks.
Well, then you're in luck. If you'd see my time during the 100, you'd know how safe you are.
Aren't guys like you worried about reputations and things?
Yours are mine.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the 1967 State Track Finals. The next event, the 100-yard dash. In lane one, Michael Beard from Hoxton High. Lane two, Jim Brady of River
there the whole night?
It was really crazy.
That's great.
It was a lot of fun.
So what's this for?
This? I don't know. Superstition, I guess.
Well, everybody's got to believe in something.
Yeah. What do you believe in?
The thrill of victory.
And the agony of being the coach's son?
It's not so bad. He just wants me to do my best.
Well, what do you want? Here. Make a wish. Come on, it'll be good luck for you too.
Okay. I wish...
What?
I wish I could get that record just for myself. Then I could tell him to shove it once and for all. I guess you got things to do, huh?
Yeah. Thanks for the ride. I'll see you at practice, Star. You know, I'd really like to see you get that wish.
Where have you been?
Out.
I know that. Where?
Just out.
Get down to the blocks. Let's go. Go. All right, Steve, Bob, Kenny. Kenny.
Get over to the blocks. What's the matter with you? I'm sorry I missed with this practice for track team members only.
I'm a friend of Kenny's.
Doesn't matter. You have to leave.
I'm here to help him out.
That's my job.
Well, you're not doing it very well, are you? He's gonna break your record.
Not unless he posts some better times, he's not.
Does that thought scare you?
Why should it?
It just seems like you've got a lot to lose. That's it, isn't it? You know, the way I see it, every time he wins, you lose.
I want you out of here.
See that? 1/10 of a second off my time.
Kenny, who's that girl after?
What?
The girl, the punk, the one with all the garbage around her.
Her name's Chloe, and she's not a punk.
I don't care what she is. She's out of your life as of now.
You can't do that.
Listen to me. I'm trying to protect you.
Right.
Will you listen to me? Now, I saw you out there today. You ran fast, very, very fast. And I think you have a chance at the school record.
You serious?
She can't break your training.
You think I have a chance?
Yeah, I do.
I don't see what Chloe has to do with this. I mean, she's helping.
She's not helping you. Girls like that help themselves. Now, trust me on this. Don't screw this up.
Dad, you're telling me that I have to go up.
Kenny, you don't have a choice. All right, take a shower, everybody. Go home. Come back tomorrow. Run fast and jump high.
This is pathetic. It's like a museum.
Except my dad really lives here.
And what about your mother? She just took off?
I think she was chased.
Why did she marry him?
That's the man she married.
Why don't you go live with her?
Judge thought it would be a more stable environment.
You could take off, you know.
And go where? My father would kill me.
Kenny, he's so wrong.
About what?
It's not about fear. It's about trust.
You think this makes you a man?
Dad.
What the hell are you doing in my house?
Dad! Chloe, wait!
You stay right here.
Look, just wait a minute.
What do you want?
I think we need to have a little talk.
Just stay away from me.
No, no. There's some things you don't understand.
Don't bother, Coach. You may have the school fooled, but not me.
Wait a minute. Now, Kenny. Kenny doesn't need you.
You don't know what Kenny needs.
He doesn't need any more advice from a little tramp like you.
I'm not afraid of you.
You ought to be, because I can hurt you.
No, you can't. Your record's going, Coach. Kenny's gonna break it. And when it does, you're going right along with it.
26, 27, 28, 29, and 30. On your feet, okay. Tomorrow we have the time trials. Are we gonna be ready?
Yeah!
And on Saturday, we have the county finals. Are we gonna be ready?
Yeah!
We know we'll be ready. We're gonna start with 75. Big jumping jacks, go! One, two, three. Okay, sprinters, I want you to fall out. Mike, Jimmy, Kenny, let's go. I just want to see how well you're going to do, pal. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Why are you still here?
She's doing this to me.
What are you talking about?
It doesn't matter. It's over. Right? You told her.
No, I didn't.
Well, then that's it, then. You're through. You're off the team.
You can't do that.
Oh, yes, I can. I just did.
Dad, you have to let me run. I can do it.
No, you won't.
Listen, I am going to run tomorrow. And I'm going to beat that record.
The record is mine! And nobody's gonna break it!
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the 1967 State Track Finals. The next event, the 100-yard dash. In lane one, Michael Beard from Oxton High. In lane two, Jim Brayton out of River Ridge. In lane three, the current record holder in this event, David Hood. And in lane four, the strong contender in this final from Hollister High, Billy Bolt. And out of the blocks, David Hood with that customary fast start. Brayton and Beard right behind him. Come on, Billy. Push, Billy. Push it. Push it. And look, coming on hard in lane four, Billy Bolt. Bolt is surging ahead. He's past Hood. He's got a shot at the state record. 10.2, a new state record in the 100-yard dash for Billy Bold of Hollister High.
See the race.
You were great, Dad.
Billy Bolt built his life on a single moment of glory, and though he coached his son for success, he never really wanted him to achieve it. But all records are meant to be broken, and the more fiercely they're guarded, the more devastating the final humiliation.